Aruna, women in technology is a subject that we keep talking and talking years after years. Can you say in your 20 years career that we have evolved a little and what should be done in order to increase the women, the market share of women in this area?
So I would say there is a lot more awareness in the community around being able to get women embrace in various different STEM careers. But have the numbers improved? I've seen a little bit of improvement, but not a whole lot of improvement. But I would say that there has definitely been a lot of advancement and investment from all technology companies. I live in the Silicon Valley, I live in San Francisco, and I can tell you that every company out there has made measurable programs in order to basically increase the number of women across the board. If you see in the news, Google has it on their calendar to basically have 30% women by end of, I think, 2020. Every company out there has a measured number where they actually want to hire more and more women within technology and STEM. I would say, even though there are measurable programs in order to get more and more women to come embrace STEM careers, the challenge is much more deeper than what the world actually looks at. Getting women to stay in a STEM career is hard, but getting women or young girls to in fact actually pick a STEM career is the first step which people actually need to invest in. And I don't see a lot of investment around that particular area. How are you actually going to create the future technologists if you don't actually have programs in place within universities, within schools, where you encourage a lot of young girls to actually embrace a STEM career? And this, in my mind, I think is an area of investment which needs to happen in every country, in every geography across the world. For example, if you see young girls get intimidated, like when they are, you know, 6 or 7 years old, they'll have a dream of being an engineer, a doctor, a lawyer, whatever STEM career. But as they grow into their teenage years, given the social pressures, they actually get pretty intimidated. They think that they're not good enough. Their girls usually tend to stereotype, and they are also very self-critical. They might be as good as a boy, but they'll actually think that they're not good in math, they're not good in science, and they'll basically, you know, pick a non-STEM career. So schools need to have good awareness programs, and one of the best ways to basically bring about a lot more awareness within STEM is to bring a lot of people in technology, women who are in that particular nationality and country, where schools need to bring in those people to come and talk about their careers, right? So you have to create that social economic infrastructure in order to get girls motivated, in order to embrace a STEM career much more earlier on.
And in addition to schools, I mean, we have the whole environment, adding families, for example, to this. Do you think companies can work on that in partnership with the schools or with social workers? So they teach families and school how to put the girls to embrace STEM careers.
So that's another big program which is happening all over the United States. And I think we're also doing it here in Brazil. A colleague recently shared this with me. So there are several programs which have been created, like Girls Who Code, Tech Girls Croc. The charter and vision of those particular programs are to basically get young girls to basically start programming at a very young age. A lot of the companies have invested in non-profits like that. So for example, we within CA Technologies have partnered with Tech Girls Code, Tech Girls Rock, and Girls Who Code. We are a strong partner with them. We run programs in different schools. High schools, we go to those high schools, we spend a couple of days in order to run camps, in order to teach girls to actually start programming. But and so it's little by little, step at a time. I would say the underlying foundation is out there, but there needs to be a lot more women who can basically can come back and embrace that, right? So they should be able to go and talk to universities. It's all about creating the role model, being able to create that excitement in that young girl in order to actually pursue a career in STEM technology. I don't see that much enough, and I think we within CA are trying to do that. I personally go to all of the middle school and high schools, because my girls, I actually had a major challenge getting them into a STEM career, even though I am a woman in technology, because of the same stereotypical reason. My girls used to think that they're not good in math, they're not good in science, had to invest a lot of time. And I would, and because of that, I give back to the community and I go to the schools, but I would encourage every woman in who already has a good technology STEM career to do that same thing, to go back to the schools in their neighborhood and actually talk about their career.
You said you live in Silicon Valley, right? Has anything changed in this matter there? I mean, this whole work from several companies and how they are embracing it. Can we see changes right now?
Yes, I can definitely see the changes, because I think every company out there in the Silicon Valley has a mission in order to have X amount of women within their workforce. And you can see the targeted programs here within CA Technologies. I'll give you an example of that. Within our recruiting discipline, you know, we actually make sure that for every requisition for a job which is out there, out of the candidate pool, out of every four candidates we get, one has to be a woman. We will not even accept people within the pool if it is all male dominated. Another example I can also give you is we pay double referral bonus if a woman gets hired than a man actually getting hired. I'll also give you an example of these some of the changes which I've seen in the Valley. The number of board positions have actually increased in 2017. Right. Previously, women holding C-level roles, board roles were very, very low. But right now, there are a lot of organizations out there. There is a foundation which was created by my mentor, Jerry Elliott. She is the executive vice president of sales at Cisco. She created boardrooms.net, specifically focused on being able to get women in leadership role into more board positions. And there are organizations like that which have basically championed the cause, and you can actually see the increase in women in leadership roles.